Karlovskiy to serve. We are ready for play here in Dallas. Start for Karlovskiy, the 24-year-old out of Moscow. 275 in the world, got to 218 late last year in October, as we mentioned, though. So many of those ITF points coming off in December. Has already been all around the world here in 2019. Koblenz, Berlin, France, Germany. Then played in Cleveland last week. Round of 64 loss there. This is not the way you want to start, especially indoors. Break chances for Harrison Adams. To see that though from Adams. You never know how many opportunities you're going to get, especially on an indoor court against a guy in Karlovskiy who can serve not huge, but he tends to serve at a very high percentage. So go after it aggressively. I certainly appreciate that. Attempt from Adams. Bigger serve, 110 from Karlovskiy, sliding it away from Adams, and an ace gets us to one love. So Adams missing out on his initial opportunity. We are off and running. As we mentioned, this is the beginning of the main draw here. Already in is Brouwer of the Netherlands, straight set winner over Martin Redlicky earlier. Gomez and Cressy closing out their second set over on court number one, but just two courts here in Dallas. As a result, the days will be long, but we will be here for every single match as we get into these 48 draws now at the challenger level in 2019. Here's Harrison Adams, love one. Thank you. 24 years of age, comes into the week at 4:47. Played at Texas A&M, was all SEC, was an All-American on the doubles side 2015. Same team as the Rinderneck, France, Jackson Withrow. Hold to live there, and Adams certainly seems unimpressed by the situation so far. One all. You never know how young players are going to handle it. I shouldn't say young, he's the same age as Karlovskiy, but you never know if players are really going to struggle playing up to this level. Karlovskiy, meanwhile, didn't have a breakout challenger event until Winnetka last July. Huge 4-0. As we mentioned, serves at a very high percentage typically. Still yet to look comfortable here on the morning. Might be out a little bit earlier than he was expecting, with that first match going pretty quickly in straight sets. This time for Evgeny Karlovskiy. We are on serve early at 2-1 here at the RBC Tennis Championships of Dallas.
Give me a racket and watch me go. Because I won't come back the same.
Sometimes I'll come back with scratches and scrapes.
Or with stories of great shots.
And close shaves.
Of wins for the history books. And of losses I'll never forget.
But watch me smile.
Say good game.
And put my racket away for now. But not for good.
Because I'll have seen what I can do.
And I know greatness.
Greatness is waiting.
Sign up with Net Generation, official youth tennis of the USTA.
Adams serving at 1-2. Mm-hmm. fantastic start. He's getting to about 120 on serve himself. It's taken him a little bit of time to really develop as a pro.
Oh!
From a match on clay in Palm Coast, Florida last week at M25. And this is his first challenger since last November. Interesting. I think if you just gauged ages based on looks, you'd assume there's a 10-year difference between these two. That forehand doesn't even get to the net, and it's a great chance now for Karlovskiy. Crushes that forehand. Seems like it might be a little bit up and down there from Adams on that forehand wing here today. But, well, players have now fallen off a break chance to all. As we mentioned, Noah Rubin awaits the winner of this one. Rubin will have some points to defend starting in April of this year. Looking to make his first push towards a top 100 in the world. Inside the top 100 into our main draw here in Dallas with Mackenzie McDonald, Ryan Harrison, and Riley Opelka all making appearances. Of course, a couple of bigger names on the doubles side with Isner. Bit of a one-off for him playing doubles with Alex Kuznetsov. And Nick Kyrgios playing with Mitchell Krueger this week. Nick was training with Jack Sock this week here in Dallas. Jack was planning on playing this one as a wild card, but a thumb injury keeping him out. Are playing Fortnite and other video games quite a bit. I'm surprised there aren't more thumb injuries, to be perfectly frank. Karlovskiy, 3-2, middle of the first on the USTA Pro Circuit.
Give me a racket and watch me go. Because I won't come back the same.
Sometimes I'll come back with scratches and scrapes.
Or with stories of great shots
and close shaves.
Of wins for the history books. And of losses I'll never forget.
But watch me smile.
Say good game.
And put my racket away for now, but not for good.
Because I'll have seen what I can do.
And I know greatness.
Greatness is waiting.
Sign up with Net Generation, official youth tennis of the USTA.
Unbelievably, Maxim Cressy has continued his unreal January now into February. Another win for him here in Qualies after winning Cleveland yesterday. 3-6 just moments ago.
15-9.
Over Emilio Gomez. Unreal what he's been able to do. Absolutely, just being picked apart on that backhand wing. Forehand is much more potent for him. That's a great forehand stretch, and you can hear there's going to be a little bit more of a partisan crowd here. Texans. They support their fellow Texans, there's no doubt about it. Really is, it seems to me here in the States, it's Texas and California, they're the two states where you're likely to see state flags. Much more so, though, in Texas. Somebody once told me that this is the only state in the union where they do mandatory state history lessons. I think that's correct. That's not my apologies. That serve and volley is absolutely destroyed, picked apart, and wiped away. Deuce now, second straight deuce game for Adams to contend with. Fantastic from Karlovskiy. Not only was he able to just defend and make a ball, but a threatening one as well. Just dipping over the net, he gets a second look at a break chance.
Thank you.
gives Karlovskiy the break in trading backhand. Now seeming to favor Mr. Karlovskiy, if Adams can't run around to hit that forehand, trouble will ensue. 4-2 in the first. And that despite the fact that Karlovskiy, this is a woeful serving performance for him, just 42% so far. This guy is easily top 100 level in terms of the technical side, the physical side. Going to be much more about the mental side for him. But with this kind of forehand power that he's able to bring. Now really powering things up. He's got it to 5-2 heading into the ball change here at the RBC Tennis Championships of Dallas.
Give me a racket and watch me go. Because I won't come back the same.
Sometimes I'll come back with scratches and scrapes.
Or with stories of great shots
and close shaves.
Of wins for the history books. And of losses I'll never forget.
But watch me smile.
Say good game.
And put my racket away for now. But not for good.
Because I'll have seen what I can do.
And I know greatness.
Greatness is waiting.
Sign up with Net Generation, official youth tennis of the USTA.
First serve for Adams, serving new balls here at 2-5. Everything has gone downhill in a hurry. Good has Karlovskiy been with that little backhand dipper. Again, Adams this time able to find a good response and guesses right on that pass from Karlovskiy. Karlovskiy with a nod of the head to towards Adams there. That was a laser just missing from Karlovskiy. And game points for Adams. To get those free points right now because not much else is working. He's won 13 of 15 first serve points, has Adams just 3 of 11 on the second. Music comes on as Karlovskiy going to attempt to close this one out at 5-3. You never know if you need a little extra pump up right before you try to close it out. He's an EDM fan. I don't know much about the music scene in Moscow. I would assume EDM is pretty popular over there with the kids as well. It's just fantastic. Again, backhand after backhand has been solid there now. And then just that ability, knowing that Adams is unlikely to take backhand line, just runs around, takes that risk, and a huge forehand up the line. 10 points. Set number one. Turn on the music. Karlovskiy, 6-3 in the first of the RBC Tennis Championships of Dallas.
Give me a racket and watch me go. Because I won't come back the same.
Sometimes I'll come back with scratches and scrapes.
Or with stories of great shots.
And close shaves.
Of wins for the history books. And of losses I'll never forget.
But watch me smile.
Say good game.
And put my racket away for now. But not for good.
Because I'll have seen what I can do.
And I know greatness.
Greatness is waiting.
Sign up with Net Generation, official youth tennis of the USTA.
Here in Dallas at the TBRM Racquet Club, Mike Cation with you. Mike C. Tennis is how you can find me if you want to interact throughout this match on Twitter. If you're watching challenger-level tennis for the first time, welcome. It is pretty exciting stuff, and we're happy to have you along for the ride. And we do welcome those interactions. It's Harrison Adams now. So we're going to start set number two, slider away. Number one on the day. Adams. He's in a precarious spot, right? There are not too many ATP points available for guys in his ranking class. 447. He's going to have to start winning some. Futures level. Of course, now call it a world, idea of a world tour. Events or get that ITF ranking high enough to get into some challengers. It's going to be a tough run down. That forehand just misses long for Karlovskiy. There's that Texas crowd getting behind Adams. Hold to love. One love here in set number two. Match just about to get underway. Or just has gotten underway in the last 45 seconds over on our secondary stream. Me and Brody and Joao Souza of Brazil. Brody, another one of these guys who needs to find some wins at the challenger level so he doesn't slip down to the ITF level. Blumberg Mio is up next here, followed by King and Song, and Hiltzik Uchida, all as part of the day session here as Karlovskiy serves level one. Now a stretch of 10 straight points on serve for Karlovskiy. Back-to-back holds two love. One all. Just a little bit more. Well, I really like that decision too from Karlovskiy. Knew he was going to get an odd bounce off of the miss, but still manages to flat out that forehand right to the left hip of Adams. Adams does well there to block that backhand back. Same pace, more so the spin, the top spin off of that low flat ball to his forehand. Does so very well there. Nice knee bend. Simple roll through. That's the ball. That ball just kind of dies through his forehand side. He can't get that necessary up and down. Karlovskiy looks to put a stranglehold on this one. It's a break chance. That's well done. A high pressure situation. All that time to think about that forehand puts it in a perfect spot. That's a moment where you expect to see some unproven players get a little bit tight. No such problem there. Deuce now. Appropriately punished for not getting much on that backhand. And Adams with a game point. You feel for Adams, just mentally more than anything. But the first time talking to himself a little bit in between points. Got the forehand on the run. That is absolutely perfect from Evgeny Karlovskiy. Second look at a break chance. Fantastic on that stretch. Once again, it's Adams. A little bit of a safer first serve. 15T with some kick, not bad.
Advantage.
But Karlovskiy will get another look. Up a pair of free points out there, especially to get one on a second serve, 92 mile per hour kicker out wide. That is massive for Adams. Another deuce. Difference here, isn't it? Every once in a while, you just see Karlovskiy. Not only does he have that same pace, but he has a little bit more in terms of that willingness to go for that extreme angle from a good 4 or 5 feet behind the baseline. It's just a different level. Break chance once again. Once again, serving himself out of trouble, another deuce.
Advantage, Adams.
Second ace of the match and of this set. Chance to escape this danger for Harrison Adams. First of the set for him. He's got four on the day. They all came late in that first set. Yet another break chance for Karlovskiy. Baseline points are going the way of Evgeny Karlovskiy. He's got a set and a break lead now, 2-1 at the RBC Tennis Championships of Dallas.
Give me a racket and watch me go. Because I won't come back the same.
Sometimes I'll come back with scratches and scrapes.
Or with stories of great shots
and close shaves.
Of wins for the history books. And of losses I'll never forget.
But watch me smile.
Say good game.
And put my racket away for now. But not for good.
Because I'll have seen what I can do.
And I know greatness.
Greatness is waiting.
Sign up with Net Generation, official youth tennis of the USTA.
That's Karlovskiy. 2-1, still having some major issues with his toss here today. It hasn't hindered him on the day, but again, with the potential against a very good returner in Noah Rubin. In his next, if he gets through this. It's obviously something he will want to get worked out. But serving at 45% now on the day. Just an unbelievable target. When I've seen Evgeny Karlovskiy, when he gets locked in and has time, he is really good. He is top 100 capable, no doubt. But that's the trick, isn't it? That is what makes this sport such a challenge, staying locked in for extended periods of time. There is one person applauding for Evgeny Karlovskiy. It is his coach. It's like the state of Texas against Russia. I don't know if that qualifies for the new Davis Cup format. It might. Probably get some matches going, right? If we actual Texas residence right now. You've got Isner. That's his meat check.
59.
You've got the Harrisons. You could put together a decent little Davis Cup team from Texas. It'd be fun. Just going through the motions at this point. Unless Adams can catch fire.
Game.
Adams. So a simple hold for Adams. To get us 2-3-2, middle of set number 2 on the USTA Pro Circuit.
Alright, Tony, 2 games. Thank you, sir. Got a new ball.
Give me a racket and watch me go. Because I won't come back the same.
Sometimes I'll come back with scratches and scrapes.
Or with stories of great shots
and close shaves.
Of wins for the history books. And of losses I'll never forget.
But watch me smile.
Say good game.
And put my racket away for now. But not for good.
Because I'll have seen what I can do.
And I know greatness.
Greatness is waiting.
Sign up with Net Generation, official youth tennis of the USTA.
With you here, Mike C. Tennis on Twitter, Karlovskiy.
3-2.
Another ace for him, this time slider out wide, 97 miles per hour. Now in the all whites, gearing up for Wimbledon apparently, but to take that big risk with the return, I think he's going to have to. And the way Karlovskiy is playing, he's not going to have a whole lot of looks. Well, Karlovskiy's given away a couple of points here, so Adams, this is a huge moment for him. Back to that initial break chance that he had in game number. number one. He would be a go in the return. Let's see what he does here. Yeah, it doesn't get a chance to. Nice, safe first serve. Again, going slider away from the forehand of Adams to deuce. Serve over and over again as Karlovskiy looking to get that serve percentage up and solidly over 50%. And he has now done just that with that particular serve. Clicks up to 51 and clicks up to 42 as well. That might have been the best chance that Adams had here in set number two. That's just the feel you get. It really has been that driving ball to his forehand, to Adams' forehand, that has really been a talking point for this match. To the forehand. Third ace of the set. I love that serve. 99 miles per hour out to the corner. Game point for Adams. Wonderful. Adams from deep in the court finds the pass, gets it to 4-3 in the second.
Give me a racket and watch me go. Because I won't come back the same.
Sometimes I'll come back with scratches and scrapes.
Or with stories of great shots.
And close shaves.
Of wins for the history books. And of losses I'll never forget.
But watch me smile.
Say good game.
And put my racket away for now. But not for good.
Because I'll have seen what I can do.
And I know greatness.
Greatness is waiting.
Sign up with Net Generation, official youth tennis of the USTA.
Karlovskiy once again is testing his ball toss before this series game gets underway at 4-3. The majority of his points coming in the summer. So in terms of finding an opportunity to make a jump, it comes here in the first half of the year.
Yeah.
Karlovskiy. That should be a pretty simple volley with Adams off of the court. Again, great effort there from Adams. He's scrappy. Coached by Steve Denton, the legendary coach at Texas A&M. Decision for Krychek to focus only on doubles at this point. Partnership right now with Artem Sitak, the Kiwi. Right now, taking on a couple of Brits, Battleridge and O'Mara, and they're down a set and a break. The two seats this week in Montpellier. It's interesting, I did a podcast last year here with Luke Bambridge, who trains with Texas Christian University here in Dallas, and he was telling me about the goals he had set for himself in terms of rankings. And now Luke Bambridge, ATP champion, achieve some of those goals. Great to see. Amazing how some of these guys can come through the challengers and really achieve their dreams at the highest levels. 5-3 here, another ace for Adams. All five of these have come in set number two. That's the third hole to love for Harrison Adams on the day. But now he needs to find a break. It's Karlovskiy who will serve for it in a moment.
Give me a racket and watch me go. Because I won't come back the same. Sometimes I'll come back with scratches and scrapes.
Or with stories of great shots.
And close shaves.
Of wins for the history books. And of losses I'll never forget.
But watch me smile.
Say good game.
And put my racket away for now. But not for good.
Because I'll have seen what I can do.
And I know greatness.
Greatness is waiting.
Sign up with Net Generation, official youth tennis of the USTA.
Serving for the match 5-4 that are going to come into the broadcast booth. That's not a good sign. When you hit your broadcaster, you know something has gone horribly amiss. That's our broadcast booth. I'm way too high. Way too high here at the Hamilton Family Stadium Court. Here comes Harrison Adams.
Thank you, sir.
Nice answer. This toss issue that dealing with is all over the place. Just have clicked over the 1 hour mark here on court. So far in his quick chances, he's got two more looks now. It pays off for Harrison Adams. He's leveled us 5-all. Listen, these serve percentages for Karlovskiy on an indoor court shows just that he can be very up and down with it, and it almost feels like he's adjusting something on the fly here early in the season. But it finally does him in. All that, and Adams is not out of the woods yet. That's just to get level. Now you've got a nose out in front. 5-ball to the forehand. Once again, the problem. Hard from Harrison Adams to get himself back into that point, into a neutral situation, but the forehand lets him down once again. Karlovskiy, three break chances. Just too much, and Adams broken to love. Karlovskiy will serve for it once again when we return to the RBC Tennis Championships in Dallas.
Courtney, you can go around if you want.
Give me a racket and watch me go. Because I won't come back the same.
Sometimes I'll come back with scratches and scrapes.
Or with stories of great shots.
And close shaves.
Of wins for the history books. And of losses I'll never forget.
But watch me smile.
Say good game.
And put my racket away for now. But not for good.
Because I'll have seen what I can do.
And I know greatness.
Greatness is waiting.
Sign up with Net Generation, official youth tennis of the USTA.
Stadium, 7-6-5.
missed first serve that has been on repeat all day. Certainly has made this match very difficult for himself. And again, it might not really cost him here, but a step up in class against Noah Rubin, if he's able to finish this one out. And it looks like this time might be a little bit easier. Match points, Karlovskiy. To love closes this one down. Evgeny Karlovskiy, first one to advance to the round of 32 here at the RBC Tennis Championships of Dallas, 6-3, 7-5 over Harrison Adams. So certainly has some issues in terms of just working on that serve percentage. You can see Josh Brace, our chair umpire, declining to shake hands with both guys. I know there's some cold and flu symptoms running through Dallas right now, and here's our chair umpire among those affected. Some more great action coming up next. It'll be Will Blumberg and Vincent Millot of France as we continue here at the RBC Tennis Championships of Dallas.